Hello friends, how are you all? I hope you all are doing very well. I am here again with a very delicious, healthy, nutritious recipe full of protein and very, very yummy. But before moving on to the recipe, please subscribe to my channel for all the healthy recipes, for all the healthy lifestyle tips and a glimpse of German life and style. I will be making today paneer but with a twist. Paneer is Indian cottage cheese. It's different from European paneer or Turkish paneer. In Turkey, it is called paneer. In India, it is called paneer. In cottage cheese. Normally, you get the paneer in white in color, normal plain paneer. But I will be making paneer with full of herbs and spices of your choice. So, let's take a look at the recipe. I am taking 1 liter of full fat milk. You don't have to take low fat milk because in low fat milk quantity of paneer is very, very low. Fat is very low. So paneer quality is also doesn't turn out to be good. I have tried it and that is how I know. Then for spices, I can use black pepper, red chili flakes or whatever spices you want. Oregano I am taking. If you have coriander, you can also use coriander leaves or petersilie. And rosemary I will be taking. For making the paneer, I will be adding vinegar to the milk. You can also add lemon juice. So instead, you can use either vinegar or lime juice. Vinegar should be white vinegar. It should be without any flavor. Don't use apple cider vinegar or balsamic vinegar, for example. It changes the texture and color of the paneer. So before putting the milk, I have little bit washed this pan with a little bit of water, and excess water you can actually throw it out. But in this pan, this is to ensure that milk doesn't stick to the pan. It's just a hack, and then I will be adding milk. So I will boil the milk. That 1 liter of milk was a little bit less, so I have added 600 milliliter of milk more. So that paneer quantities also turns out to be a little bit good, not so less. So you have to keep it on a high flame and you have to keep on stirring it so that it doesn't stick to the pan and there is also no cream formation on it. So when you're stirring it in the other gas, I will also roast some cumin seeds. Because as I told you that I am making masala paneer, so I will be roasting some cumin seeds and adding to it just for a little while to give it a nice smell. And in the meanwhile, I will keep on stirring it. So now the milk is about to boil here. So I will have slightly roasted these cumin seeds. Don't make it black, just slightly roasting will be sufficient, and add to the milk. If you don't want to roast, you just want to add like that, then also you can do that. Then I will be adding spices of my choice like rosemary. I will be adding oregano or even pizza seasoning will be good. Add black pepper, chili flakes. As much as you want. This chili flakes already have some salt in them. And then you will again mix it. Milk should not stick to the pan, otherwise it will burn. So that is why we have to keep on stirring it. Look, now the milk is boiling. Milk has boiled, so I will be adding vinegar. You have to see yourself that how much vinegar is needed to make the milk curdle. Look, it is again getting separated. You can see like this. So I will be adding more. So around 5 to 6 big spoons of this vinegar will be needed, or lime juice also the same way. So you can see it is getting separated.
it is not so clear because of the spices, but you can see the this milk has curdled. You have to turn off the heat at this point after adding vinegar or lime juice. Turn off the heat. So this liquid white is called your whey. Whey is also full of protein and you don't have to throw it away. I will show you how to use it. So you can see that all the its water and this paneer is getting separated from the whey. So here I have taken a white muslin cloth or cheese cloth, and here it is a sieve to make this whey separate from the paneer. And you don't have to throw the whey, it is full of protein, it's very very nutritious. This is a thing which is used in protein powders which you buy so expensive in the market, so please don't throw it, just drain it out, keep the separate. Quantity of paneer also depends on the quality of your milk. Sometimes paneer is very good, milk is of very good quality, so lots of paneer can be made from the milk. And sometimes there is not so much fat in the milk, then also there is not much paneer doesn't come out of the process. So here you can see this is the paneer left and this is your whey here. Keep it like this, so that let it cool it down for 5 to 6 minutes so that it gets a bit cooled down so that you can squeeze it later on easily. For me, taste of vinegar is not such a big problem, but if you think that it is too vinegary a taste, or this from lime juice you want to remove that that smell and taste, you can just wash it with the plain water and then squeeze it out. For paneer to set, you have to really really squeeze it out very well. You can also just hang it on the tap to make the process easier. Hang it on the tap if possible, or at a high surface so that all the water drains out. So either you can hang it on the tap, or you can also just put it on a plate and cover it with any heavy thing you have. Whatever heavy things you have in your kitchen, just do it to give it a pressure and let it set for 1 or 2 hours. So when paneer was set, I put it in the fridge overnight. So now paneer is set this morning, and now I will show you how does it look. Look, it looks so good. It's properly set and you can eat it just like this, as a treat, or you can also top it off on the salads, or you can use it in paneer based recipes like butter paneer masala, mutter paneer or palak paneer, whatever is there, cottage cheese is used, you can use this paneer in that recipes also. If you don't add spices, then paneer looks white in color, because I had added spices and oregano, so its color is a bit different, but it's very yummy. So I will show you. And if your paneer is not set, like it is broken, so you can just make paneer sabji just like that, and just eat it as a salad. Sometimes the mistakes happen and paneer is not set, so we can use it anyhow. And the whey which was left over from we had drained, you can use it in making curries, any gravy. This is very full of nutrition and don't waste it, don't throw it out. You can also use it to make paneer next time, or just straight away put in dal or any gravy based sabji. You can cut cubes of your choice of size of your choice. And look, this is how it will look. Very healthy, full of protein and full of taste.
Hit the like button if you like the recipe, share it with your family and friends, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. Please write to me in the comment box your suggestions, your opinions, what do you want to see on my channel. I will see you in my next video. Till then, take very good care of yourself. Stay healthy, stay happy, and stay blessed. Bye-bye.